Shake, 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 shake.
Hello, hello. How are you doing today? As you can see, we're going to have a experiment regarding about Apple Garde. Apple Garde sent this to me. They sent me the Apple Garde stain repellent sprays. They sent me the Apple brand cream shoe polish in the color of black. They sent me a leather cleaner and they sent me a leather conditioner. So there we go. So these are the things that we're going to use today. And then this is my mom's bag, if you remember that. This is the Speedy bag that I gave her during Mother's Day. This is her Louis Vuitton Speedy, and it's in the size of 30. So today we're going to work on all the Vachettas of it. To protect that one so that it's not going to be oily and it's not going to be stained, and it will be free from water stain, oil stain and stuff like that. Today we're going to use a water wipes, which is to clean this up first before anything else. I'm going to use a painter's tape because this one, it will guard all the monogram, and this is safe for this particular one because it will not gonna go seep into the canvases. And then if something will happen, spills or anything, I do have this cloth just to wipe it up. So today, if you're into this one, if you wanted to know more about Apple Garde's product, stay tuned. Don't forget to use my code to the Apple brand Garde product. I don't have anything to do with that one, just to promote this one for you guys, because I know for a fact that this is a good product to use on your Vachetta like this one. I've been using this one for about a year now with my Vachetta, and then for this one too. I showed you one of this one on my Instagram when I was working on with my Danube, Louis Vuitton Danube shoulder bag. I use this one, and then it's effective, and it's really making it water repellent for the Vachetta. So what are you waiting for? Go online. If you are interested in getting all these products from Apple brand, use my code. So the first thing that I'm going to do is to really clean this up because it's been a while. And then after that too, is that we're going to spray this. Typically, you're going to spray this one for about twice so that it will be able to really protect the Vachetta. So I'm going to show you some of my other bags that does have the Vachetta on it so that I'm able to use the Apple Garde rain and stain repellent on those, and then so you'll see it yourself too. So for the meantime, we're going to get the water wipes. Water wipes, I use this one because this is 99.9% water and then 0.01% extract, so that they use. So this is really good for the for your leather and then for the Vachetta and for the canvas. Vachetta or Vachetta, whatever you call it, or wherever part of the world you are, however you pronounce it, it's the raw leather that's untreated of the bag. So in this particular bag, in this Louis Vuitton bag, Speedy, you're going to see a lot of it. The tab, the handles, there's a tab in here, and even the piping along the side. So those are the ones that you're going to protect, because why are you going to protect it? If you're not going to protect this one, what's gonna happen, it will darken because of the oil stains that you have on your fingers when you use the bag, because usually you use the bag like this. So typically the older version of the bags, you will see it under here, under the handles. Those are the ones that you're going to see that it will darken. It's not going to be honey patinaed, but it's going to be dark. So you're going to have a dark handle on here and then lighter on the top. So which is kind of like, it's not really a good looking bag, a good looking handle for your bag. So yeah, and then also it's going to be carefree if you're going to put a rain and stain repellent on your handle, so that if there's a splash of water that it got into your bag, you're not going to worry about it too much. So let's go and do that for the meantime. So I take this, some of this one. And this is really nice because you get this one at Target or Walmart, but I got mine at Target, so yeah. And then here, you're going to clean it up. There you go. So you're just going to just really wipe it down with this one. So yeah, and all over the place so that it's going to be so clean. So that's what you're going to do. So here's the bag, and then the second thing that you're going to do is to let it dry. So you're going to let this one dry for a little bit because you already cleaned it up. Yeah, this one is safe because I always use this one, and then after you clean it, after you use this one, it's really going to be so clean, and then you can really tell on the wipes that the bag is dirty. So for the meantime, since we're doing this, I'm going to clean some of my bags, and I'm going to show you how to do that. So this one is my favorite bag, and you have seen this one, that I carry this all the time. This one is my toiletry pouch 26. This is my love of my life, aside from Seb. I'm just kidding, baby. The other good thing about the toiletry pouch 26, excuse me, is that the only part that has the Vachetta is the tab, the zipper tab. Zipper tab, that's the only one. So which is really good, so that this is really a carefree bag, and then that you can really use around and stuff. It does have inside, it does have lining that's waterproof, so inside. So yeah, next time I'm going to show you what's inside my bag for this one. This is the new acquired bag that I have. This is the Etude Voyage GM, and I really like this because it really fits my laptop. And then it's more than, and then it also fits the 8x11 papers that you use for your homework and stuff. And then the good thing about this one, that's the only Vachetta that you're going to have on this. And then I have a video on this one, and then you will see it in the next video. So inside, and then there's a Vachetta on here too, the tag that it has. And then yeah, and then there's only one pocket on here, and then there's the, of course, there's the date code in there. So yeah, so but I really really love this bag. So we're going to treat this one too. So that's that. We're going to make sure the bags are already dried up. And then what we're going to do with that one is right now, it's already dry. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the tape. So I'm going to tape it up so that we can liberately do this one on the bag. So what I'm going to do is I use a paper towel. So this is how I do it. I make sure that one end we're going to get one, and then the other end we're going to get another. So I'm just technically doing this. I'm just going to tape it around it. There you go. Anyway, it's fine because this is just a, there you go. So you're just going to go along it so that later when we do this, you can liberately put the sprays, that you don't really need to worry about the bag at all, because it is going to be protected and then it's going to be fine. So why do you need to put two coats? I put two coats because the first one, you just want to make sure that it is fully covered. The second thing, the reasoning behind it is that you want to make sure that the bag is already soaked in with the repellent. So this is what you use too when you paint the bag. I use this one too when you paint the bag. I have some videos for that for you guys, to show it to you how it's going to be done. And then because of course you want to protect the bag all the time, right? So, and then I'm going to put this one on here. There you go. So that later, when this one is said and done, you can just liberately like that on this one. So it's going to be okay. So now I'm doing the same thing that I do on the other side. And it's okay if you're going to splatter it with the repellent, because it's supposed to be a repellent one, so it's okay. It doesn't really matter, or it's not really going to do any bad on the bag. Anyways, it will protect it more. And then you can always use a cloth to clean it up. So yeah, but with me, what I want to do on this one is that I really just want to make sure that every single thing is covered and protected, so that because I'm an impatient guy, that I wanted to just do it and spray it like so, that I don't really think of the neighboring things about this. So now the bag is ready to go. There you go. So the bag is ready to go. So these are the major parts of the bag that needed to be sprayed at anyway. So that's perfect. So here's our bag, and then here it is now. I'm going to now do the spraying off the bag with the rain and stain repellent. So with this one, you're just going to liberately do it. I'm going to put this one on this, so it will be protected. So you're just going to spray it so, like so, and then probably we'll put it up a little bit. So, like that. So that's why I really want to protect the bag itself, because I really want to put more than the usual on this bag. especially the crease, especially the handle, the inside handle of it, because that's the one that we usually have to hold all the time. And then let it be, let it dry up a little bit. And then it will dry up. So we'll give it for a little bit of time. So basically what we're trying to do is to soak it with the apple guard so that it will be really protected. So this is the first coat. I'm gonna let it dry for a while and then we'll get back to this one and then we'll redo the process, okay? So that's what we're going to do. And then I will show it to you how is that going to be done and then how is it going to be protected. Right now, I'm just looking around if there's a spot that I missed, especially the under part of it, because that's the one that you just wanna really protect. So for the meantime, that's gonna be it. And then we'll time it, how long is this gonna be, like this. While we're waiting for all this, I'm already going to put one on this one. This one I already protected all the time with this. So there you go. And then because under and over it does have the thing, the bachetta, I'm going to put one on the under side of it too. So yeah. So I want to put ample spray. So that's how it looks like, kind of like dark. There you go. And then for my new bag, for the new bag, we'll do the same thing. And then I'm trying to protect it from all this. There you go. Shatter of it. I hope you can see that. And then just deliberately put some of it on top and on the bottom. There you go. So it's already protected. I let it be. And then later, we're going to check on the progress of all. Hold on. And then later, we're going to check on the progress of all these bags. And then after that, we'll spray it again for the second time around, just to fully protect the bag and make it water repellent or oil repellent. So yeah. We'll get back onto this. So after like 15 minutes, it's already dried, and then we're going to do the same thing with this one so that it would be able to manage all this. So I'm going to do the same thing again. I'm going to make sure that everything is covered again. So shake, 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 shake. And then we're going to put more of this. Just make sure to really put a lot, because this one will last for a year or two, so that's the good thing about it. That's why you just want to make sure that everything is covered and everything is soaked in. So that's that. And then this one, so this one I really love it, because I use this one for this, and look at the honey patina color of it. So I'll do the same thing too. Soak it in with that, with the apple guard. both sides of it because you want to protect it, because this is the only one on this one. And the last part of this is this one. I'll just cover it with my hand because it's just little anyways. There you go. And then like I said, if there's anything excess on the side, you can just clean it up anyways, like so. Okay, so we're gonna wait for about 24 hours for this one to really fully dry, and then after that, you're gonna be able to use it. How about you guys? What do you use to protect your Vachetta for your bags? Do you use Apple brands or do you use any other brands? If you know any other brands that you use, let me know, comment below, and then we'll talk about it. I hope you learned something from today's video, and we're going to check this out if how it is tomorrow morning. After 48 hours. Ta-da! It's now protected with the Apple Guard rain and stain repellent. So yeah, it's pretty. There you go. It's still drying a little bit, as you can see on that, but it's gonna be gone soon. But the most important thing is it's now really protected. I hope you find this video informative and useful. So thank you very much for watching this experiment that we have. I hope you learned something, and I hope that gave you a confidence of using Apple Guard or any rain or stain repellent that you use with your bag. So yeah, thank you very much for watching. Have a wonderful day. Do what makes you happy. Bye. So don't forget, when you're buying Apple Guard rain and stain repellent, I do have a code on the items that you're buying on their website or on Amazon. You can use that one in there.